Hello, I'm Adobe Parker, and this is lecture 12 of the module Water. In this lecture, we are going to talk about disinfection processes, also called as sterilization, which is nothing but the process to remove microorganisms. It is important for you to know that water after initial treatments like sedimentation or filtration still contains a small percentage of pathogenic bacteria. Hence, to avoid waterborne diseases, water used for municipal or drinking purpose must be free from these disease-producing bacteria. The process of destroying disease-producing bacteria or microorganisms from water and making it safe for use is called disinfection. And the chemicals or substances which are added to water for destroying bacteria are known as disinfectants. There are three methods suggested in your syllabus for disinfection of water: by bleaching powder, by chlorination, and by ozone. So let's get started with the first one. Disinfection by adding bleaching powder. This method is used for small quantity of water. Bleaching powder, chemically that is calcium hypochlorite. In practice, about 1 kilogram of bleaching powder is thoroughly mixed with about 1,000 kiloliters of water and allowed to stand for several hours. Now let's see how this disinfection action takes place. Calcium hypochlorite on hydrolysis produces calcium hydroxide and chlorine. This chlorine again undergoes hydrolysis to produce hypochlorous acid and hydrochloric acid. And this hypochlorous acid is a powerful germicide which kills the bacteria. However, only calculated quantity of bleaching powder should be used to avoid bad taste and smell to treated water. As you can see here, bleaching powder introduces calcium in water, thereby making the water more hard. This drawback can be avoided by using another method, that is by chlorination. Chlorine is the most widely used disinfectant throughout the world. Apparatus used for chlorination is known as chlorinator, which is a high tower having number of baffle plates. Water and proper quantity of concentrated chlorine solution are introduced at its top and then get thoroughly mixed during the passage through the tower, and at the bottom we'll get sterilized water. For filtered water, about 0.3 to 0.5 ppm chlorine is sufficient. Here chlorine on hydrolysis produces hypochlorous acid, which we know a powerful germicide. This hypochlorous acid reacts and inactivates enzymes in the cells of microorganisms, which leads to death of harmful bacteria. Chlorination is effective and economical method, which can be used at low as well as high temperatures and introduce no any salt impurities in water. However, excess of chlorine if added produce unpleasant taste and odor. Disinfection of water by ozone. Ozone is an excellent disinfectant but highly unstable. Hence, it must be created on site and added to the water by bubble contact. Ozone is produced by passing dry and cold oxygen through ultraviolet light or silent electric discharge. For carrying out the disinfection, ozone is released in water in a sterilized tank. The contact period is about 10 to 15 minutes, and usual dose strength required is 2 to 3 ppm. And ozone is passed in water because of unstable nature, it's breakdown producing oxygen and nascent oxygen. This nascent oxygen is very powerful oxidizing agent which kills the bacteria and also oxidizes the organic matter present in the water. This method is quite expensive, but it removes color, odor, and taste without giving any residue. Moreover, excess use of this is not harmful since it is unstable and decomposes into oxygen. So this is all about disinfection of water. Thanks for watching. See you next time.